I would say right now, walking back in by myself, obviously it's a little different because you're by yourself. You're not with other people, but I don't feel uneasy or anything like that. Like, I don't feel like there's anything here that's going to try and mess with me or get me or anything. Obviously, but it's just more of like you're by yourself. You're in a location by yourself, and that's everybody's natural ability is you're just going to be a little hesitant by yourself in different places you're not comfortable with. But right now, I don't feel too bad at all. Yes. Okay. Can I sit down? Okay. Who is haunting the coconut sitting next to the polterpod? I didn't hear anything, no. You gotta do something with your mic. I mean, that's super loud in my ear. Oh. All right. Oh, let me turn. Yeah, I got you. Yeah, hold on. Talk again. Perfect. Yeah. Who is haunting the coconut? What name? Can you give me a name? What name is haunting the coconut? What is your fascination with the alcohol and cigars? Nothing. Nothing different at this moment. It's just quiet. With the coconut, we don't know much about your backstory. We know you like alcohol, cigars. We don't know if you're a female, you're a male. Do you want to tell us your name? Are you male or female? Nothing. All right. Set the coconut back. Okay, so we did a séance on the first night. What you do is you're tapping into everybody's energy. They're all putting it into the board. to try and just, if anybody wanted to feel anything or talk to anybody, they could bring themselves forward and make themselves known. I would, like, same thing. I would say, like, being back in by yourself, I don't really feel any energy in the table or not. But, again, like, the table's cold. But the table's always cold. So, like, last night when we were doing it, you had the fire going and all that kind of stuff. And you could see the, you could see that the flames might get a little bigger at times. But your also eyes are closed, so you may feel more of the flame. But when you feel more of the flame, it's just... because your senses are taking advantage, because your eyes are closed, you're going to feel everything else better. You're going to hear things more. It was a unique experience. I've never had done one of those, but it was cool. But being back in by yourself, I can see how it's unnerving to people, because, again, you're in a dark place. You don't know. You did a seance here, and it supposedly has things going on. So I could see there being an unnerving factor being in here by yourself. Yeah. This. Okay. So, if anybody in here wants to talk to me, I'm sitting at the table. I have this polterpod next to me. Feel free to come over here and talk to me a little bit. And just give me some. I'm going to ask, is there anybody here with me? You can talk through the polterpod. What is your name? If anybody's here, what is your name? God. Does anybody in here want to sit down with me and talk to me? Does anybody in here want to sit down and talk to me?
God.
I couldn't make out what it said, though. So I heard something on the polterpod, but I couldn't make out what it said. Can you say that again, or be clear? You don't have to say the same word, just be clear. Would you like to sit down and talk to me? The thing is, I'm not making out, like, I hear things as well, but I can't make out what the word is. Alright. I'm gonna turn my light on for a second, so I can actually see where I'm walking. Where would you like me to go, D? All right. Stay in here. Okay. All right, so the entity that is in the cave that supposedly can't leave, can you tell me, are you male or female? No, I heard female voices. I didn't hear male voices. Alright, so because I heard a female voice come through this, I'm going to assume it's a female. Can you tell me your name? Can you tell me the name of the entity trapped in this cave? So, I think I heard Leslie, but I don't know. It sounded like an L. Okay. So, if your name is Leslie, you're female, what entity are you? I hear more female than male, but I'm not, like that, to that question, I did not get a response. So I'm going to ask, how old are you? How old is the entity that is trapped in this cave? Later, we're doing that a little bit, so I can come back out and we can send Taylor. Okay, we'll send Tate and Nick in. Yeah.
So, I mean, you went in, you actually got a little something. Tell us, like, from beginning to end, kind of what you experienced.
I will say, when we first walked in, he asked if I felt anything. I did not really feel anything. I will say, you just have the unnerving feeling, because obviously by yourself, you're in an unknown area by yourself, so everybody's gonna have a little unnerving. But I never felt like scared or off or anything like that. So we went into the wicker room. Didn't really, I picked up the coconut, set it down. Didn't really make out any names or anything on the questions I asked. Tate and Nick go next. We get a break.
Oh, okay.
All right. So you were touching the coconut. Okay.
Yeah. So I was touching the coconut, asking who it was. Upset, but I couldn't get anything on the Volta Pod. Nothing I could make out. I heard things, but nothing that I really could make out and understand what was being said. So then we moved to the dragon room. When we walked into the dragon room, had me sit down or whatever. Like, and then asking questions, and at times you might hear something like when I ask a question like, do you want to sit with me? I couldn't make out something. I know you said you heard something. I don't know what you heard. I couldn't make out what it was saying, if it said anything. The only thing I will say that, I don't know if it constitutes, because that table is cold. So when I put my arms on it, in general, I just got the shivers, just because the table is cold. So I don't know if it's because of the table being cold and I put my bare skin on it, and that made my body just get cold because it's colder than the rest of the area, or if it was because I was asking this question. But I only got it that one time when I put my hand on the table. So I don't know if that constitutes, but I was also asking a question at the same time about sitting down and talking. So I don't know on that aspect.
Okay, so what I thought I heard over the thing when you said, hey, do you want to sit down and talk to me? It sounded like it said talk. So I didn't know, what do you think you heard?
So I didn't hear anything that started with I thought I heard like, nope or something like that. I didn't think I heard talk.
Okay.
But I couldn't make out what it said.
Yeah. Did it sound like you heard talk, Ev?
To be honest, I didn't think I heard that much.
Ah, okay.
I didn't think I heard that much.
Okay. And then, after that, we asked a few more questions, got up and walked to the cave area and walked in there. And I asked a couple questions, and the only word I made out on the box was the name Leslie.
Okay. That's what it sounded like. It said Leslie. I don't know what it was, but I heard. I thought I heard Leslie come across the spirit box when you asked for its name. I asked the name, and that is the name I felt like I heard was Leslie. I don't know the meaning behind any of that, but that's what I heard at that moment. And then, not gonna lie, it's probably on the camera. That damn mouse scratched right behind me. Got me a little off guard. But I heard it scamper.
Was like, oh.
Yeah, but I heard it scamper right away, so I knew it was the mouse. Okay. And that's the only unfortunate aspect, that in the cave, you're going to hear things, and it's hard to, is it mouse or is it something else?
Yeah.
But that's the only time I heard it. I didn't hear anything else the rest of the time I was in there. I will say you do feel the most unnerving aspect when you're in the cave versus any other part of the house, in my opinion.
Okay.
When you're in there by yourself, you feel more unnerving than I felt in the dragon or the wicker room.
Okay.
That's what, you know, yeah.
Yeah.
That's a repeating pattern.
And it is. But I also feel like that also plays in because it's a cave, you're built down a little bit, so the furthest part of the house, you're completely under it, and there's water. Water's a conduit, supposedly, so that plays all into it, and there's a lot of horror decor in there, which plays into it. So,
okay. What's in the coffin? What's in the coffin?
So I opened the coffin. It's just fake bones and a fake little dragon head. I did that. It's more of a Halloween decoration type thing than actual anything in there. If it was big enough, I would try to get in, but it's not big enough.
Okay. All right. We'll see if we can get another Leslie or female out of somebody else. All right.
Now we'll get Tate and we're going to get Nick together.
Okay.
We'll get them.
All right, Tate, are you ready to do this? They're sending us both in right now.
Going right now, cold, wet, nasty, tired.
It's a night.
Perfect for ghost hunting.
It's a predicament.
All right, we're going in.